One of the five missing victims of a boat capsize incident in the waters near Sandakan, Sabah on Thursday was found drowned today. The deceased, a 42-year-old woman, however, has yet to be identified. The search and rescue operation for the remaining victims, involving over 100 personnel from various agencies, resumed at 7 a.m. today. The Malaysian Maritime Enforcement Agency, MMEA, said they were then alerted by a fisherman about the body floating in the waters between Pulau Nunuyan Laut and Pulau Berhala at about 12:30 p.m. Sandakan Zone MMEA Deputy Operation Director Maritime Commander Muhammad Khairul Anwar Abdul Majid said the search is now focused on three more victims, namely a 27-year-old man identified as Ibrahim January, his 18-month-old daughter Nuraini, as well as an 8-year-old girl whose identity was still unknown. A 38-year-old man suspected to be the tekong, or boat skipper, identified as Sido, was initially believed to be among the missing victims. However, based on information given by survivors of the incident, the man was believed to have fled after he swam away from the scene, using a fuel container to stay afloat. Yesterday, five people, two men and three women, aged between 19 and 29, were rescued by the Royal Malaysian Navy at about noon. 4 hours later, the body of one of the victims, a 7-year-old boy identified as Kimar Herman, was found. The rescued victims are now being treated at the Duchess of Kent Hospital in Sandakan and are reported to be in stable condition. It was reported that the boat with 11 people on board capsized about 5 nautical miles from Pulau Nunuyan Laut due to turbulent sea conditions at 6:30 p.m. on Thursday, about 30 minutes after the vessel departed Pulau Tagana in the Philippines.